Are you being referred for a cardiac CT scan? In this video, I will explain what the cardiac CT scan will involve so you know what to expect on the day. If you're new to the channel, welcome. I'm Hafiz and I'm a cardiologist training in London. Here I explain heart conditions in a way that is easy to understand and also provide teaching for medical students and junior doctors. If that interests you and you want to know more about your heart and learn about heart disease, then hit the subscribe button and bell icon so you get a notification every time I post a video. A cardiac CT scan is usually requested to investigate cause of chest pain. The scan has two parts. It can do calcium scoring and a CT coronary angiogram. Calcium scoring measures calcium in the heart arteries. Calcium means atherosclerosis, the buildup of fat on the vessel wall. The more calcium, the greater the likelihood of heart disease. This step is done without contrast. CT coronary angiogram shows us the circulation inside your heart arteries, called the coronary arteries, and identifies any blockages. This is a step that requires contrast injection. We can also identify blood clots in the heart or lungs, look at any calcium on the heart valves, and identify any major abnormalities with the bones, although the scan isn't specific for these findings. Cardiac CT scanning uses X-rays, but the radiation exposure is very low. It is rapidly becoming more widely available, but not every hospital currently has the capability to have the scan, so you may be referred to the nearest specialist hospital. The scan itself is painless and very quick to perform, lasting a few minutes, but expect to be in the department for 30 to 60 minutes. When you arrive, the receptionist will book you in. You'll be asked to remove all metal objects around your neck and chest and change into a hospital gown. Before you have the procedure, you will be asked a few safety questions about any medical conditions you have and if you've had X-ray dye before. You will also have your heart rate and blood pressure measured to ensure it is safe to give you beta blockers. You will then have a plastic tube called a cannula placed in your arm so that the contrast can be administered. It also gives us intravenous access to give you beta blockers if we need to slow down your heart. You may also have been prescribed a beta blocker for a few days prior to the scan to bring down your heart rate. Once you're in the scan room, you'll be asked to lie down on the scan bed, and you'll have sticky dots attached to your chest so we can monitor your heartbeat. The CT scan takes pictures of your heart in between your heartbeats when your heart is still. If your heart is beating too fast, we may need to give a short acting beta blocker that works very quickly to slow down your heart. They are selective, so they mostly work on your heart. Most people don't feel anything when the beta blocker is given. The radiographer will also give you a spray under your tongue called a GTN spray. This contains nitrates, which work by dilating the blood vessels of the heart so they can be more easily seen on the scan. Some people experience a headache after the administration of the spray, but it usually goes away after an hour or so. During the scan, you'll be asked to breathe in and hold your breath each time, and we will practice the breath hold with you before starting the scan. For the CT coronary angiogram, the radiographer will warn you just before the contrast is administered. You may feel no difference, but some people get a slight warm sensation or a metallic taste in the mouth after the contrast is given. It may also give you a feeling of wanting to go to the loo. This is normal. After the scan, you will be monitored to ensure your heart rate and blood pressure remain stable before sending you home. Once the scan is complete, it will be reported by a cardiologist or a radiologist, and the results will be sent to the doctor who requested the scan. Remember to bring a list of all the medications that you take and don't have any caffeine on the day of the scan. This includes tea, coffee, chocolate, and any energy drinks. We recommend someone brings you to the hospital or you take public transport. This scan is very helpful to reassure patients, as most of the time it's normal. If there is evidence of heart disease, you'll likely have other tests like a stress test or an invasive coronary angiogram to potentially treat any blockages of the coronary arteries. I hope that was helpful, and thanks for watching.